big changes are coming to your lineup of Pixel devices, and there's AI in everything. Here are the best announcements from Made by Google 2024. Hey friends, I'm Tasia Custode, and my feet were on the ground at Made by Google 2024. Can you even believe? There were a ton of announcements from hardware to Gemini to Android, oh my. And a good starting point may be that the entire lineup of Pixel devices is seeing some notable changes. So let's talk about Pixel 9, Pixel 9 Pro, and Pixel 9 Pro XL. The first thing you'll notice is the new look with an all-new camera bar, which, by the way, doesn't just look good, but should also improve durability. Pixel 9 features a dual rear camera system with a 50-megapixel main lens for incredible image and video quality. The 6.3-inch Actua display is 35% brighter, and Google has also improved their Gorilla Glass with Victus 2, which they claim can handle drops and scratches. Pixel 9 has the latest Tensor G4 processor and an upgraded 12 gigabytes of RAM and a longer battery life. It can charge up to 55% in about 30 minutes. Pixel 9 starts at $799. And when it comes to the Pro models, we have two sizes this time. These are probably the devices I'm most excited about. For sizing reference, Pixel 9 Pro is now closer to the size of Pixel 8. Those like me with small hands, rejoice. The Pixel 9 Pro XL is closer to the size of the 8 Pro. The Pixel 9 Pro and Pro XL are gorgeous. You'll notice the newly redesigned camera bar featuring an AI-powered full-stack camera experience, a triple rear camera system with a 50-megapixel main lens for incredible image and video quality. On the front is their best front-facing camera yet, a fully upgraded 42-megapixel front camera with 30% better light sensitivity. With Pixel 9 Pro and Pro XL, SuperRes Zoom comes to video, and you can enhance your videos to 8K with Video Boost. They're claiming this is the best video on a smartphone. It's got that improved Super Actua display that's brighter and has 15% thinner bezels for increased display size. So the display size of Pixel 9 Pro is 6.3 inches and Pixel 9 Pro XL is 6.8 inches. So to be clear, you're getting the same awesome specs, but in two different sizes now. Both have the new Tensor G4 processor and 16 gigabytes of RAM. I could go on and on about the Tensor G4 chip, but for now, let's just say it is responsible for incredible camera and video capabilities and lightning fast app launch. What's really nice is that they get 1 year of the Google One AI Premium plan. They get 7 years of OS Pixel drops, and when it comes to battery, they offer Pixel's fastest charging ever with all-day battery life. There's a new vapor chamber so they can charge up to 70% in 30 minutes. Pixel 9 Pro starts at $999, and Pixel 9 Pro XL starts at $1099. And we can't talk Pixel without talking about the all-new Pixel 9 Pro Fold. Pixel 9 Pro Fold has a new and durable design. When it's folded, it works just like a regular phone with a 6.3 inch outer display. When unfolded, it's got what Google says is the largest display on a phone. You can multitask in split screen and enjoy big screen entertainment on the 80% brighter 8 inch Super Actua Flex inner display. Pixel 9 Pro Fold is the thinnest foldable on the market, so it can better fit into your pocket. It's weather resistant and has a durable hinge and Corning Gorilla Glass Victus 2 on the outer display and back. And the all new hinge is made of stainless steel with an aerospace grade high strength aluminum alloy cover. So it'll hold up fold after fold. It's also got Tensor G4 processor and 16 gigabytes of RAM. Now, when it comes to the cameras, it's also got the triple rear camera system with AI built in. There's a 48 megapixel wide camera, 10.5 megapixel ultrawide with macro focus, and 10.8 megapixel 5x telephoto lens. There are also a couple of great new features. First is the Made You Look feature. You can take a pic of your kids or pets, and their view is of a cute little animation to keep their attention so that they are looking right at the camera while you are framing the shot however you like. Brilliant. There is also YouTube multi-view for streaming live sports. Pixel 9 Pro Fold starts at $1799 and is available in porcelain and obsidian. And Satellite SOS is now available on Pixel. They are the first Androids in the US to do this, and it's free for the first 2 years, starting in the US. And with that, believe it or not, we are still not done. So let's move on to some other devices, this time wearables, and we'll start with Pixel Buds Pro 2. These were designed using 45 million data points from ear scans to come up with the optimal shape for maximum comfort. They've got a new Tensor A1 chip, and they are also 27% smaller and therefore lighter. They've got active noise cancellation that Google says can cancel nearly twice as much noise as before. They've improved clear calling, and they've also got conversation detection. So they use AI to tell you when to start speaking. Your music gets paused and the earbuds switch to transparency mode when the conversation ends. The music resumes automatically and goes back to active noise cancellation without you having to take any action. The Pixel Buds Pro are $229. Another wearable that's getting an update is the Pixel Watch 3, which is also available now in two sizes, 41 and 45 millimeter. So both the 41 and 45 millimeter have a larger display size thanks to smaller bezels. Pixel Watch 3 is fully integrated into the Google ecosystem, so you can get more done right from your wrist. The Nest display is coming to your watch as well with two-way audio, so you can tell the delivery driver to leave that package at the door. You can also use your watch as your Google TV remote. And I feel like so much of this year's Made by Google was about Gemini on Android. So now let's touch on some of those Gemini on Android updates. Your assistant has been completely rebuilt with Gemini. So now you can speak naturally, just like you would with another person. It can understand your intent, follow your train of thought, and complete complex tasks. You can now bring up Gemini's overlay on top of the app you're using to ask questions about what's on your screen. So for example, you can find specific information about a YouTube video you're watching. You could also generate images directly from the overlay and drag and drop them into apps like Gmail and Google Messages. Gemini Live is also officially here and rolling out now as we speak. And I talk a little bit more about Gemini Live, and you can watch that video by tapping right up here. But it's safe to say that Gemini Live is probably going to change the way you interact with your device. You can pick from all different voices now, you can have natural conversations and just tap to pause or interrupt to redirect the conversation. And of course, when you're done with a conversation with Gemini Live, you're going to have the transcript right there where you can pick up at any time. This is part of Gemini Advanced. But for now, let's focus on a couple of my favorite new features coming to your Pixel. Courtesy of Gemini Nano, weather on your Pixel is not only going to give you the information you need, but you'll also have an AI weather summary. And there's also an all new screenshots app. So this is designed specifically for you to make lists and take screenshots. It will organize all your screenshots for you. And then you can just ask Gemini to pull up relevant information without you having to search through past conversations and figure out where you put stuff. So think gift list ideas when you screenshot something for someone. Super handy. But there are a couple new camera editing features that I am freaking and geeking out over. First, Magic Editor is wild. Autoframe in Magic Editor will recompose a shot for you. That's right, it'll improve the composition of your shot. You'll get a few options and the generative AI fills in the blanks for you. At Made by Google, they showed this with someone sitting in a field, and I'm telling you, it even recreated his sneaker that had been cut off. It was incredible. Absolutely love this. There's also Reimagine. So with this, you're gonna type in whatever it is that you wanna see in your image in a prompt. So you'll select what you want to change, then you'll make a prompt and change it. So this is being done using Imagine 3. So here we went from sitting in a field to sitting in a field of flowers. They added a hot air balloon at one point. It's incredible. Can you even? Okay, next is an all new feature called Add Me. And for this, they brought out Jimmy Butler to help them with the demo. This is completely insane. Just see for yourself. With Add Me, you will snap the photo first. Then you will swap with someone in the photo, and then you go sit or stand in the photo, and the AR guides the photo taker to get you into the right spot. You snap the photo, and it composes it for you with you in it, even though you weren't in the original shot. What? This is the perfect travel photo editing feature if I have ever seen one. We would be here all day if we talked about all of the announcements from this year's event, so I've linked to the entire Made by Google event for you in the description below, should you want to watch it in all its glory. I still can't even believe my little feet were on Google soil